So yesterday we had the topic what we are discussing is about global warming and the total pollution what we are seeing. We can see that this is as I said for you, cyclic order. We should have the summer season, winter season, and rainy season, but it is not happening. Why it is not happening is because of this pollution and what is that? Because of the deforestation, we can see that is the cutting of the trees. We are not getting fresh air, and this pollution. What we know that this where this pollution will go? This all pollution will mix with the atmospheric air, and it is not allowing to form the clouds. Why? Because the temperature is very high at that particular time. What we can see means there are no cool breezes touching. There are no cool breezes touching the atmosphere. Because of this, what is happening means we are not having proper rainfall. If we are having also, it is leading to floods and drought. As I said for you, in this two cases, something is happening. Two are very difficult for us. If we are getting the floods also, it is difficult. If it is drought also. What is drought means totally we are not at all having a bit of water to drink. Means there is means water was less in ground. The groundwater will be reduced. Then we will not have cultivation, agriculture purpose, and we won't have water for the domestic activities also. So that is totally problematic if it is drought. Then floods means overall the water will be contaminated and the people will suffer with this contaminated diseases, and we will not have proper drinking water. So yeah, in these two cases, if it is floods or drought, two are difficult for us. So what we have to do to reduce this pollution? What we have to do? We have to plant the trees. Planting of trees, or the next one is stop usage of vehicles. We have to stop usage of more vehicles. Then we can say that we can reduce the pollution. But nowadays the people are not ready to go for a small distance also. They will be ready to go on their bikes or on car or like this. We have to, who are going to suffer? We have to understand we are the people who are going to suffer with this pollution. So let us plant number of trees, and next by that way what will happen? The pollution will be reduced with the fresh oxygen which was released from the plants and trees. And next one is by reducing the uses of vehicles, we can stop this carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and nitrogen oxide. What are the pollutant creating chemicals will be reduced, and reducing of chemical industries also. So industries must be reduced. Next, uses of vehicles must be reduced, and afforestation, planting the number of trees also. In this way we can reduce the pollution, and we can see a cyclic order of the rainfall. Means in cyclic order, we already told that from June to September it is the rainy season. As we said, automatically when we reduce the pollution, what will happen is this cyclic order will be taking place. Did you understand? So coming to the points of what we have learned is that first one we talked about, our point is about rain and how it comes from the water bodies. As we said, what are these water bodies? Already talked with you, the rivers, ponds, lakes, seas, and oceans. And after this, we discussed about what is evaporation, how the evaporation process takes place. Means from these water bodies, the water will get evaporated and they will form the clouds. And what are clouds? Okay, which type of clouds? What are the clouds, and which type of clouds will form the rain? Means all clouds will form the rain. Will the clouds move from one place to another? We discussed. Will the clouds move from one place to another? Next one, will all clouds will form rain? Then, if not, which type of clouds will form the rain, when the clouds will be condensed. Then here we discussed about condensation process, and when the clouds condenses, what we can see that they will be converted into rain. And we discussed about what is the uses of this rainfall, and what is this when we discussed about evaporation, clouds, condensation and rain. Here these four processes we discussed about water cycle. Here we discussed about the water cycle, how the cyclic order of this evaporation, condensation, clouds and rain is taking place. We discussed it in water cycle, and we discussed about how many types of rains we can see, as acid rain, then the fish rain. Next one, what we discussed, hailstones. When the climate cools, means normally when it cools only, when the cool breezes are touching the clouds only, we are getting rain. But still the temperature is very cool, then we discuss that this water, which is in the liquid form, they will be converted into solid form, and it will change into hailstones, and we will have hailstorms. That particular rain we discussed, and the next we talked about how the fog will be formed. Okay, then in cool temperatures, what is our body temperature and how the surroundings will be, we discussed. And if we are we are cutting the trees or these, how we are going to be affected with the pollution, how the rainfall will not be there. These all points we have discussed in this lesson. And still more, if anything is there, just go with the points, and if anything was there, you can ask me, I'll clear it. And these are the points which you have to revise. A small massive following will be given for you. You try that one. Then we can go with the objective. So you can see here, the first one is global warming, second one is acid rain, third one is solid form of water, fourth one is gaseous form of water, and fifth one is the state of the water. Coming to the next options here. First one is water vapor. So see here, to the part B, you are having water vapor, deforestation, 3, pollution and ice. In this 5, you have to match this one for which one will suit to which: global warming, acid rains, solid form of water, gaseous form of water, and state of water. Next, whatever deforestation, tree pollution, and ice, try to match this in and means please put this in your classwork. Next, the objective part. To the objective, the first one is the moving air is called dash. The southwest monsoons occur in the month of fog is formed during dash season. The northeast monsoons occur in the month of dash. Then the process of water vapor changing into water is called dash. So these are the objective part, and not only this, another 5 more are there. Try to answer this one, and if you follow the lesson, it becomes easy for you to answer this objective part. The next one is See here the next five lines. Whatever helps to form dash, deforestation and pollution leads to dash. If the raindrops are very small, they are collectively called dash. Dew formation on grass leads to what? The last and final one, the process of changing water into water vapor is called the dash. These are again only 10 lines I gave for you, and 5 marks are following. Try to answer them. Okay.